Welcome back to the report. The subject of the caliphate has been contentious for both Muslims and non-Muslims. Ever since it was declared back in June by the Islamic State, many Muslims across the globe have denounced the state. But conversation around the caliphate and what it means has continued. Reporter Yasmin Khatoon has been following the story.
Behind me here, British Muslims have come to discuss ideas around the concept of a caliphate. The people here don't accept the declaration by Islamic State in Iraq and Syria, but the question is, why?
This conference was organised by global political party Hizb ut-Tahrir. The group were one of the first to come out and reject the declaration made in June. As a group which has been calling for an Islamic State for over 60 years, this came as a surprise to many. Speaking to the British media representative for Hizb ut-Tahrir, he says their stance is clear.
Suddenly that within your group that you announced that the emir of your group is the Khalifa for the Muslims and you demand bay'ah, this is not the Khilafah. It's well known, this was very clear to many Muslims across the world, and that's why our position likewise is very clear, and we and all Muslims need to keep working and yearning for the real Khilafah.
Many have rejected the caliphate established by Islamic State on the basis that it doesn't meet Sharia conditions and is seen as extreme.
It's not the Khilafah. They do not manifest what is the Khilafah, a man who controls a whole territory. We find that in Iraq, ISIS is fighting. In Syria, ISIS is fighting with many of the groups opposed to Assad, and that raises many questions in itself. And in Iraq, ISIS is in alliance with the tribes, did not take bay'ah from the people of the region who really control power.
Around 800 people turned up to the second of three national conferences on the topic, and people from all over Europe came out to find out more about the concept.
Where the society is now, it's like disgusting the things that you see, so much fitna everywhere, and it's important to work towards Khilafah, and it's a fard upon us to work towards it as well.
Being young and stuff, you see how much pressure there is in terms of like fashion, music, all the industries out there, and you see that kind of like you're training yourself to live like a kind of typical life of going to college, then going to university, and living your life based around money. And it's all capitalism, and you know, you kind of want to live your life more for the sake of Allah.
Passers-by in the local area reiterated the same sentiment we heard at the conference.
I think being an Islamic State and establishing an Islamic State is farad upon every Muslims, and we must always work together to unite and build an Islamic empire or Islamic world and live under the Sharia. But to be honest, the things that I'm seeing in ISIS, from ISIS, I don't think that's exactly how Islam is portrayed. I mean, I don't think we're there to conquer someone. We're there to give dawah and spread Islam through peaceful means.
Any group can come along and say, this is the caliphate, this is the Khilafah Rashida that we've been looking for. But in reality, when the Khilafah is established, the West would not be sitting around and watching. We know straight away they'll be attacking at every single port, every single possible spot of the Islamic State they will attack. They will try and get embargoes, etc., etc., etc. So what ISIS has declared as the caliphate is far from what a caliphate is.
With hundreds of people turning out in London to discuss the topic, my feeling is that however much it's tainted, it's still a firm desire in many hearts. Yasmin Khatoon, The Report, Islam Channel.
In the studio to discuss this is Abdul Andalusia, who's founder of the Muslim Debate Initiative. And on the phone, we're joined by Sheikh Hatim Al Haddad, an Islamic scholar and activist. Welcome to you both. There couldn't be a worse advert for a caliphate than ISIS, could there? Or do you think that their existence has provoked debate about the issue?
Well, I think that perhaps prior to ISIS's self-proclamation, some Muslims probably thought that a caliphate was like King Arthur and Camelot. It was a fantasy. It would be brought in the end times. But I suppose now, because there's a lot of debate around ISIS's proclamation and why or why not it is a caliphate, Muslims have now realised just how realistic a caliphate can be. And so much so now that we're actually having a debate about ISIS, whether it's a caliphate or not.
Mm. Sheikh, but I mean, if this is reality, people may wish that it's long delayed.
Yeah, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We have to be careful here because Islamic caliphate is an Islamic obligation, generally speaking. And there are certain conditions where the Islamic Caliphate can be established. Not any claim for Islamic Caliphate is does really represent the real Islamic Caliphate. So we have to hold a neutral position and an Islamic position. The absurd and the anti-Islamic activities carried out by the ISIS should not put us off of the concept of the Islamic Caliphate. Islamic Caliphate is an Islamic obligation. Establishing a caliphate will be helpful even for non-Muslims to understand what does Islam all about. It will help non-Muslims to speak to Muslims. There will be one representative for the Ummah, and the various non-Muslim countries will be able to communicate with all Muslim groups. Even the Islamic Caliphate will be able to control Muslim groups from doing harmful things for the non-Muslims, not like the situation now done by the so-called Islamic Caliphate in Iraq and Sham. So we have to be careful and hold the Islamic position, which is a moderate position and a neutral position. Yeah.
Sheikh, what would be the conditions, if this is an illegitimate caliphate, what would be the conditions for a legitimate caliphate? And I think the question that many people will ask is, and where does political consent come into this? This would be a question asked of any political project from the far left to the far right. Where do we get our say?
Yeah, this is a very good question. Okay, first of all, let us understand what does caliphate mean, the word caliphate. Khilafa means representation, okay? Or either one of its political meaning is representation, or the main meaning for it is representation. So the word khilafa should, by its essence, should represent the vast majority of Muslims. Because the Khalifa or the Caliphate, he is the representative of the vast majority of Muslims, which means that the vast majority of Muslims have given him the authority to represent him, to represent them.
Okay, Sheikh, that's very clear. Just let me put some of those points to Abdul in the studio. So, I mean, there's a very clear drive there from what the Sheikh's saying, that consent and democracy in ordinary terms is central here to a caliphate. Do you agree with that?
It requires the consent of the Muslims to appoint a caliphate because the obligation stems from them. They transfer the authority to this one individual of whom they form a contract of ruling with. But unlike democracy, the people's whims or desires are not the basis or the sovereign of the government. It is the law of Islam, the law of God, and the caliph is really just an executor. So he just executes the law of God to the best interpretation possible. Obviously, he's not infallible. There is difference of opinion, and he can be challenged about what he does. So,
and how does that happen? That's the question most people can ask. OK, this is interpreted. Fair enough. Who decides whether it's interpreted rightly or wrongly?
Well, the great thing about Islam is no one owns Islam. It's kind of open source code for everyone to kind of look and debate. So scholars have historically counted caliphs. Judges have in courts have counted the caliphs. Even the supreme judge or the judge of the constitutional judge, if you want to call it that, the Mahkam of the Mudhalim. And they've been impeached and removed from power. Sultan, Turkish caliphs have been removed from power due to a perception that they were going against Islam.
Okay. Sheikh, how has this conversation, this discussion around the caliphate, how has it been altered by the Islamic State's declaration?
You mean this current ISIS?
Yes, indeed, yeah.
Yeah. First of all, ISIS have not consulted the vast majority of scholars all over the world, to claim the caliphate over the Muslim Ummah. This is one thing. The other thing, if we say that if they want to claim that they have an Islamic state, they should differentiate between an Islamic state as a state, okay, not a caliphate, as a state. And here we have to distinguish between an Islamic state and the caliphate. The caliphate represents the vast majority of the ummah. It is one caliphate. The Islamic state, now we have Brunei, is an Islamic state. We have some other Muslim countries. they implement maybe 60, 70, they differ in terms of their implementation of Islam within their country. So if they were to claim that they are an Islamic state, this would have been accepted from that perspective only. Yeah. Oh,
okay, good point. That's an important distinction, isn't it? Because, you know, Iran, others are said to be Islamic states or claim to be Islamic states, but they don't claim to be the Islamic state for all Muslims. It's an important distinction.
Yes. Well, first and foremost, a lot of countries which claim to be Islamic are not Islamic. They've mixed some secular democratic laws with Islamic laws, or they have a modernist interpretation of Islam, which they implement. So they're not necessarily Islamic states. However, even if ISIS was an Islamic state, or was a state, as in one that could provide security for its own members, currently I don't think it can. I don't think Abu Bakr Baghdadi can give a public speech without fear of being a drone attack hitting him. So not so much of a caliph if he can't protect himself, let alone his people. But here's the key issue. If we look historically, the Ottomans, Sultanate, and it was a Sultanate, they were conquering Europe, conquered Constantinople, controlled Syria, fighting the Persians, conquered Iraq, and they still didn't declare themselves a caliphate until they took Egypt, because then they could claim that they were the biggest shield, they were controlling the most strategic areas of the Muslim world, and hence they could provide the protection for the biggest portion or the main centers of power for the Muslim world. So if anyone wants to declare themselves a caliphate, they have to have those credentials. And the Ottomans had to wait a couple hundred years before they were ready to declare themselves the caliph of the Muslims. So that even if ISIS are implementing Islam, and even if they are a state, they cannot claim themselves to be a caliphate any more than Hamas could claim themselves to be a caliphate, or the Taliban could, which themselves did not claim to be a caliphate. And so on. So you can't just say I'm the caliphate, and yet you only control a small fringe area or a small part of the Muslim world, and even that, not really you control it properly or securely. So really, you have to look at the historical precedents for this. You can't just say Islamic State now, I'm a caliphate. No, the situation in the Muslim world is that we're spread out. We've got different centers of power.
Just let me ask you one final question. That conference, it was organised by Hizb ut-Tahrir. They're seen as quite a marginal group within the Muslim community. Is this a debate which is now much wider than them and across the whole of the Muslim community?
I don't know if I don't think Hizb ut-Tahrir are marginal within the Muslim community, but what I would say is that the concept of caliphate is not owned by them. The concept of caliphate is owned by all Muslims. It is prescribed by the Prophet Muhammad. He prescribed this, and it's an obligation upon all Muslims. And I think that the debate about the necessity of the caliphate, or rather you should say the debate about how we implement the caliphate and how the path towards it, is certainly a conversation that's spreading around the Muslim world, and it's extremely vital it does so, because we need to see the realization of these things, because so much of our problems are rooted in the absence and started from the absence of a caliphate.
Okay, thanks very much. Well, I'm afraid that's all we've got time for on tonight's programme. I want to thank all my guests and, of course, you at home for watching. Remember, you can keep up with our Twitter conversation on all of tonight's stories by tweeting at Islam Channel and using the hashtag #TheReport. Well, we'll be back tomorrow evening at the same time. But for now, we'll leave you with scenes from East Jerusalem as Israeli police clash with protesters ahead of the funeral of 16-year-old Mohammed Sinkrot, who died after sustaining injuries in clashes with an Israeli border police unit. Until tomorrow night, good night.